Hello gamers! In today's episode I will cover Shaiya Online, a MMORPG that was really played back in the day and maybe will bring back memories for some of you. If you want to know if the game is still worth playing and if you should be playing it even in 2021, follow me into this journey till the end to find out. Okay, so let's check the classes and the character creation. Okay, so in the beginning, like always, let's talk about classes. First of all, I have to choose a race. Union of Fury and Alliance of Light. I picked Union of Fury because of some technical problems that I will discuss later in the video. Half of this race looks like a Neanderthal and the other like blood elves or some people that ate too much blueberries and got their skin blue from that cause. The classes of the game are pretty basic. Here we have Warrior, Guardian, Oracle that is a priest, Assassin, Hunter and Pagan that is a sorcerer. The character customization is nothing impressive, only some hairstyles, some kind of scars, and height adjustment. I picked like always a guardian and began my journey. Let's check the gameplay mechanics. Well, the combat is a little bit delayed. It's like I am playing FIFA. If I press a skill, it will remember the command and will execute it after the animation of whatever is doing is finished, and if I press another skill or auto attack again in the meantime, it doesn't matter, it won't cancel. The game has stopped targeted combat and is not impactful at all. At least, you have many skills that you can choose from, but they have somewhat poor effects and animation. Some of them even look pretty similar. The movement in this game is a little bit funny too. I felt like playing GTA Vice City but in a dark fantasy MMORPG. The jumping felt weird too, especially on the human race, where the avatar was able to jump like 3 meters in the air without no problem, and felt like a kangaroo. At least, the game rewarded me with some pet and I chose a little wolf without knowing it is a spawn of Satan, a blue wolf with his ribs getting out from the back and some weird looking nails like the one dinosaur that we all know. Story. In this department, I can't say too much because it felt like it was non-existent like in most MMORPGs, but let's be serious. Who played these kind of games for the story, beside the Final Fantasy XIV players? If you want story, go read a book, watch a movie or an anime, or go play a single player game. Or maybe get drunk and explore the real world, you will find some story there. I'm sure of that. Before we continue, let's ask the question of the day. What is your favorite type of pizza sauce? Comment below and let's debate this thing. Also, what kind of memories do you have with this game and what class did you play? How the questing felt. One problem that I had with the game is that I tried Alliance of Light, but I got stuck at level 4 because I couldn't do a quest where I had to buy 10 fruits and they were costing 2500 each and I had only 1700 gold and no meaning of making more gold. So then I switched to the other race. Here I got into another problem that I was getting too little experience for the questing, or I don't know how it happened, but I was so underleveled that I had to always fight monsters 4 or 5 levels higher than me and it started to get really tough. At level 18 again, I had no quest to do and didn't knew where to go at that point. I looked all over the internet and found nothing. What is more confusing is that on my other character I was so overleveled from the quests, again I don't know how, so I continued a little bit on the warrior class. Overall, the questing is nothing more than generic ones where you have to do mindless killing of X amount of monsters. So in this department, Shaiya will get a thumbs down from me. Let's check the graphics and the atmosphere. The graphics of the game are what you will expect from an old MMORPG. They are bearable. The environmental zones that I experimented in this journey was a snowy mountain area, that is the first map of this race, then a swamp, but there I did only a few quests. The monsters in Shaiya are somewhat repetitive and nothing special or cool looking, at least at lower levels. The population of the game is really low, I think I saw around 3 or 4 players and that is really bad. I saw some activity in the world chat, someone even responded to me when I got stuck in the battlegrounds, but the overall atmosphere of the game in terms of a MMORPG is pretty bland with not so many players walking around, and that is always a sad thing. Items. At least, the gear of the game is pretty cool looking and at level 14 I was already looking like somewhat of a dungeon raid leader. This game has that annoying gift, the one that will give you strong gear, here was not so OP like in other games, or maybe only on my defender class because when I switched to the warrior, I was wrecking everything. I couldn't follow my oath to you guys and myself, where I don't use those kind of weapons, but the missions from the game were not giving me no gear whatsoever, and the ones from the shops were too weak, so I had no choice. I found a lot of sockets from mobs, and it's cool that you can enchant or put crystals in your gear from your inventory, even sell items. Oh, and I almost forgot, this game has a cool filtering option on the map, and I think all games should adopt this thing where you can check what is shown on the map and what not, like quests, monsters, shops, event shops, and so on. From what I was reading from the forums, I saw that the game is pay to win. If you want to dominate in PvP and be their daddy, you will have most likely to spend a lot of cash. Okay people, before we check the pros and the cons, drop a like to help me in the fight with the algorithm beast, and if you want to follow me in the journey where I try games so you don't have to waste your time, join the legacy by using the subscribe spell button. What I liked about the game is that you can look cool from lower levels and you have a decent number of spells. What I disliked though is that the game felt really bland, with not so great combat, little player base and annoying questing progression where either I was underleveled or overleveled. Overall, I would not recommend this game to my viewers in 2021 because the game is mostly dead, and if that is not enough, the endgame is pay to win too, so I don't think it is worth your time, even for a short journey. Okay people, that's all for Shaiya, thank you for watching, and have a grindy day.